All right, we're back with the
Kraken 580 Nitro. We got the chassis done almost yesterday. Got this pod, whatever you want to call it, transmission servo pod. I'm going to wait to do the arms. I think we can get them on after I tested it. So I think we're moving on to the head, if I'm not mistaken. So I checked, this kit does not come with magnets, which is pretty poor on Saab's part for the, that's pretty cheap, man. Spend $8.50 or whatever this is on the kit. You can't put 20 cents of magnets in there, people, come on. And then, it doesn't even come with servo arms, which Saab needs. Come on, people. Alright, that's some really cheap shit there. Doing that to your customers. May you rot in hell. Alright, I'm looking for bag 9. Bag 9. Freaking Nitro. Rota head. So if I got some O-rings. One's labeled, one's not. So these are not O-rings. Those are the spacers. So we got different dampers in here. We're probably going to go with the lame ones. Two spacers, four spacers, a ton of bearings. My favorite, putting together these. Don't take these out and start confusing them. You'll hate life. You take these out. Two of those. Alright, in the trash you go. Okay. One of these is left hand, one's right hand. Saab does some nice links. Oh, they even marked it right, left now. Instead of putting a stupid little thing that you all forget in 2 days. Alright, let's see what we got here. We got the radius arms. Thank God these are plastic. No need to make these out of aluminum and then you crash. I mean, they're $30. Keep it cheap, people. Keep it cheap. Call this the Uniball radius arm assembly. And the radius arms are actually aluminum. Alright. So you can line up the little thing in there. The radius arms are here in this package. See, instead of this stupid packaging, you could spend more money and give me my freaking servo arms, but then you can charge for the servo arm, so it's win-win for you. I get it. I get it, trust me. Gotta make your money. Gotta make your money, don't you? And there's different bearings, I think. Space, no, 6 by 2.5, 2.5 by 6. So I'm not sure. Oh, this is going to fit. No, it's tension.
spacer arm go in the bearing? Well, that's a little weird. What the hell? It's just really weird.
There's not enough room.
Just the ribs.
Barely.
Let's touch it.
Man, there's barely any room.
Let's press it with a vice so it's nice and even. I'm not putting even pressure with a stupid plier because plier's closer than the end. So. Okay. So that's nice.
Yeah, and okay, that worked. The little spacer worked out.
That's a tight tolerance. Use those oxycodones.
At least Oxy gives you magnets and arms. Not sad.
Okay, those are done. All right, here's the nightmare. I have a tool for this. It's a tool to hold these. It came with the, Chinese kids in here. Cool if I could find this tool.
I thought Saab used to come with like tools or something.
So this tool came with that Taro 600 I bought. The Taro 600 is nothing more than a copy of the
logo 600 550 geometry wise. It's all it is. Like all the parts, tail, boom, they all fit perfectly, the head, swash. It's just a cop. The shitty part is that lousy frame they did. That thing's
are supposed to be 62 to 63, so we'll stay at 62. We've got a mile to go. That's good. You want good engagement on these. I'm sick of, like, Mikado does this sometimes. They'll put like four threads in there, and you're freaking balling. Okay? You know, you rely on plastic to hold the hell together. I've never had failure. Just a little off. Wow, that's short up fast. 62, like I knew what I was doing. I like that they marked these. Instead of the stupid ass line. Which you don't know if the line means right hand or left hand. It's usually left. Usually I do these with a drill, with a power drill, Stanley. I like the power drill. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give this the same as the other one. 62. So the less screwing around you do there, the better. All right, so we got our main shaft.
Hollow, it's light.
It'll bend easy to crash, hopefully. So you got to put the 90 short and the 70. I thought you had a choice. Guess I was wrong. So don't confuse these. You show them as red, they're not red. Grease. Another thing it could come with. Line kits come with it. The line cares about you. I'll use some lithium. White lithium. Of course it doesn't, it's just a carrier and all kind of grease it is. Okay, so put the 70 in first. 70 short, that's a hardness. That's what that is. We'll put the 70 over here. Goes in first on the 90. Get this little plastic stupid thing. The manual is terrible. Doesn't show you how the goes like that though. Right. What we're gonna do is grease this up real good, or else you can't. You'll have a hard time slipping it in. That's what she said. I guess this doesn't matter. Right now, just trying to get it. You could put the grease on your O-rings, but as you push it through, it wears out, right? So it's impossible to, like, get your shaft in there. Don't make that mistake. You have to put the grease in the shaft, so it's pushing the grease off the shaft as you go in. Don't be a rookie. Oh! Okay. This in the right way. Something like that. Let's get all the grease out of here. It's the last place you want grease. It's in your holes. These we will clean out with alcohol. You don't want it. You sure don't want that coming loose. This comes loose in flight, your howie's done. It's destroying itself. And it is hitting the ground. It'll destroy itself in the air before it even hits the ground. Like, you will have nothing left, I'm telling you. I've done it before. Not that it's come loose, but I've had head issues. Okay. Grip arms. It is normal to feel tight after initial assembly. The prelude up to 10 flights. Okay. We get some washers. This says it's already assembled with grease. No, it doesn't. The inner bearing is. Good, because I hate when they assemble it and you gotta like check and take it apart to see if they did the grease and everything anyway. So what's the point? I've had some that are good, I've had some that are bad. 10.
Bag of 10.
Bag 10. Bag 30. What are you guys doing today? It's gotta be bag 10, yeah. some washers that we're not going to use, maybe. At least not the first time. Alright, so these will go like that. These look dry, I'm not going to clean them. I'm going to bug some people. They're very dry. I like Mikado heads with the plastic, and they're just nice. Alright, so, shows one washer in there. You should have your two bearings and your two. So these must be the washers that it comes with. 11 by 13 by 13.8 by half a mil. 13.8. Should be an 11. Yeah. I'm getting 10, but these are not the best. By half a mil. Those are that. What was I gonna do? We gotta open this. Every single heli in the world has the larger ID. There's two IDs on these, and the larger is always in the first. So the little head can teeter. Come on. So again. Pretty obvious which one's bigger, so we'll put this one in first. So the bearing goes in next. I like one when the bearing is in. Kind of just slid in there. So you put your big bearing in. And they always flip over. Always. And still flipped over. I'm going to put some grease on the back of this. So it has grease against the bearing. Just a little bit. Don't need a ton. It's going to push off anyway. So. Okay. Now you can grease the living shit out of this thing. Your thrust bearing. There's a lot of talk about which way these go because it holds grease when you. It's such bullshit. The Mikado engineers even said, go fly your heli. That was their answer when someone asked. Meaning, shut up, it's stupid, it doesn't matter. Making a big deal out of nothing. All right, and then the washer. And then we wipe our hands. So I'm not gonna put any yet on the preload. Any extra washers. I'm just gonna put it in. That's it. Okay, that's a big mama. That's a big one, boy. What the hell size is it? Some wrenches here. What the hell's going on? Nope. We'll use the L wrenches. Is it a 4? Yeah. Show you Loctite on these.
was careful not to get grease in the threads. It's the last thing you want. It's very dry in there. Alright. It's cool they got the markings on there and everything. Very cool. What's that other? Okay. Let's get some grease on the spearing. I don't want it galling the aluminum. I think I did that in the other one. It's probably going to explode. Thanks a lot, Saab.
Thanks a lot, Saab.
Alright, very obvious, which is the big one again. Who's got all their Christmas shopping done? Son of a bitch, did I put the washer in the wrong spot in the other one? I think I did. It goes. Glad you guys were watching. How come you didn't tell me? It goes bearing, washer. That makes more sense. I got the brass or whatever washer it is. Makes more sense. Okay. So we'll fix the other side. Thread locker. Good thing there was two to do, I would have noticed my error. You dummy. I had a hard time threading this one in. So dry the threads. Now watch this one. Propensity to just spin. Alright, yes, I definitely built that wrong. Idiot. Thank you.
The next worst part is putting all those
good.
Putting all those links together for the head. Okay. One head. One head. Then we need the block. That's tail. Where's the block? Where's the head block, people? That's right in my friggin' hand, you idiot. Alright, this has two washers in it, so be very careful. See them? They do that so you lose them. Alright, the radius arm gets a washer with the sob facing out. Sob here. Goes up here. Like that. Looks like it. I can't see if they're see what they're doing here. Put the washer on. What a shitty diagram, my god. So it looks like they put it in the bottom hole. Radius arm with a little notch like that. Can I do this? So we do that. And put it in there. No washer. If you go crazy with a Loctite, you're gonna get it. Alright, a little cut out towards the arm, like that, like so, let's cut out here. Alright, makes sense to me, Jimmy. This thing with the indentation away from the screw into the nut. So I think like that. Indentation here towards there. Yep. Okay, I've said it enough times. Let's just use the red. I think this, no, this will not tighten the head. Good. I hate when they use these as the method to tighten the head also. Like this, it needs to be kept separate. Because what happens is you end up pinching the bearings too much sometimes. Okay. Next is the little arms, which should be here somewhere. There they are. We're done with this. I'm still looking for the magnets. Alright, 10-2. Throw all this shit away. Got a coffee break here. Those are really nice looking arms. Or not arms, but 27s. I don't know what that means. But I'm going to put a lot of Loctite. There's only one way for these to help people. And you go in. I'm going to put it pretty tight. Seven should be upwards. Good. You bend these and it crashed. This makes it real nice. Well, nothing's nice in a crash, but makes it nice to. I'm not shying Loctite on these. I almost want to use red, but I've never really had a problem. And to get red off. You use a little heat. Right, make sure. Yeah, make sure before you tighten this one. Your head's flipped over the right way. There you go. Or else you can't get it on. You know what I mean? All right. One very smooth, even head. It's really nice. Here's the swash. I'll take it out and toss this last thing here. It's a nice swash. That took a while to do the head and everything. Pretty sad. Oh, we're not even moving on to the head. When do we do the head? Oh, we don't put all that together for a while with the swatch and everything. Alright. Back in the bag you go. Guess we can put these on. Let's put these so. Should go clockwise. Man, so I've got nice links at least. As we go clockwise, they will shrink. So let's put this over here. All right. Next. Let's throw this clamp so it's greasy as shit. Oh! Okay. We do have to tighten the head. I need another 4 to tighten the head right. And here it is. Alright, before we forget, tighten the head before the Loctite sets up. This will probably. Oh, yeah, this will tighten the head up a lot. Oh, stayed good. Didn't get notchy. Very impressive, Saab. We'll forgive you for not including the magnets and the. I'm serious. I mean, a lot of helis, you don't get that good. It turns to shit.
Bag 11.
Tails, another one I don't like building. I don't like building tails. How cute. What a little cute shaft. Tiny. Tail loader. Alright, what parts do we need? This.